Hello, everyone. This is Colin Goble. The purpose of this program is to show you how to count the number of times the different values from the roll of two dice come up. Obviously, if we're running a craps casino, we'd be very interested in the question of how often does a 7 come up, how often does an 8 come up, how often does a 9 come up, and so on. So in this program, we're going to roll two dice at random over and over again, and we're going to count the number of times the total of those two dice is 2, the number of times it's 3, and so on. Let's take a look at the program to do that. In this particular case, we've defined a constint here, constint number of rolls. This number is the number of rolls that the program will simulate in one execution of the program. At the bottom of the program, we have the function that we had before. This function rolls a die. It generates a random number between 1 and 6 by using the rand function, which generates a random number. If we take the remainder on dividing that random integer by 6, we'll get a number at random between 0 and 5. And if we add 1, we'll wind up with a random number between 1 and 6. And the code there tells the player, as you can see, what number on the die got rolled. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's the function that's referred to here in the function prototypes. It takes no parameters, and it returns an int being the random number simulating the roll of the die. Okay, in our main program, the first thing we do is declare an array of 13 counters. Now you may ask, why are there 13 counters? This number here, 13, in C++ is the number of elements in the array. And the reason is because in C++, arrays of numbers, arrays of counters in this case, are always numbered from 0. So the first counter is counter 0, the second counter is counter 1, the third counter is counter 2, and of course the 13th counter is counter 12. The number in the square brackets is known as the index of that particular counter in the array. So in this case, therefore, we have 13 counters, because that's the size of the array, and they are numbered from 0 to 12. The idea is that we're going to use counter 2, counter with the index value of 2, to count the number of times 2 comes up. We'll use counter 3 to count the number of times 3 comes up. And we'll use counter 12 to count the number of times 12 comes up. It's worth noting that, of course, counter 0 will always remain 0 because the sum of two dice can never be 0. And similarly, counter 1 will always remain 0 because the sum of two dice can never be 1. The minimum value, of course, must be 2, one pip on one of the dice and one pip on the other dice. This little syntax here initializes all of the counters to 0. Remember, when you're programming, if you're going to count anything, you always need to initialize your counters to 0, and we've done that. We'll seed the random number generator, as we did in the previous example. We'll do that just once at the beginning of the program. And here is the main loop of the program. We're going to execute the loop number of rolls times. If number of rolls is 100, we'll simulate the rolling of a pair of dice 100 times. As you can see, die 1 is the value of the first dice, die 2 is the value of the second dice, and total is the sum of the pips on both dice. The next line here takes that total and increments the appropriate counter by 1. So, if the total on the two dice is 6, say, if the value of total is 6, then the element of the counter array whose index is 6 is the one that is going to be incremented by 1. When we've completed that, say, 100 times, there's a loop here that displays the array of counters. We start the loop with a value of i of 2, and we end it with 12. precisely because we know that the number 0 can never be rolled and the number 1 can never be rolled. And then we go on and we calculate the maximum and the minimum. In other words, which number came up most frequently and which number came up least frequently. And this code here calculates the minimum and the maximum values in the array. The algorithm is fairly simple. We take element number whose index is number 2 in the array, the first real number in the array, and we make that our candidate for being the maximum value in the array. We make a note that our candidate came from index position 2. Similarly, we make index position 2 our candidate for the minimum value in the array. Then, quite simply, we iterate a loop through the remaining elements of the array. So we start at index number 3, which is the next one after 2, and we step I in increments of 1 until we get to 12, which is the end of the array. And the algorithm is quite simple, really. If the ith counter, if some counter is greater than the current candidate maximum, and that would mean that the current value in that array, the counter that we're looking at, has a higher value than our candidate maximum, so it becomes the new candidate maximum. We set counter I to candidate maximum. Excuse me, we set candidate maximum to counter I, and we make a note that the candidate index is now the ith element in the array. Similarly, if the ith element in the array is less than our current candidate minimum, we'll update the candidate minimum to be the ith element of the array, and we'll make a note that the index that contains that minimum is the value I as we iterate through the loop. The result of this, is that when we've looked at all 12 items in the loop, whatever is the candidate maximum index is the item in the array, is the index into the array of the total of the number that occurred most frequently. In other words, the total that occurred most frequently. Similarly, candidate minimum index is the index of the total that occurred least frequently. We output those numbers. Let's take a look and run the program. If we execute this, you'll see that in the output we get indications of what happened on the 100 dice that get rolled. And then after the 100 rolls of the dice, we can see that two came up twice, 3 came up 6 times, 4 came up 9 times, and so on. So counter 2 has a value of 2, counter 3 has a value of 6, counter 4 has a value of 9, and so on. Counter 12 has a value of 6. The total that occurred most frequently turns out to be 5 because a 5 was rolled 16 times. The total that occurred least frequently was 2 because a 2 was rolled 2 times. So the element of the array that contains the least number is element number 2, which contains the count of 2, and the element of the array that contains the greatest number is index number 5, because the count in there is 16. That's because the total of 5 was rolled 16 times. Okay, I hope this demonstration has given you some insight into how to handle arrays. I think you'll find it helpful when it comes to the application that you have to write to decode the encoded or encrypted text. Thank you.